Well, Prime Minister Theresa May is calling on internet companies to do more to help fight terrorism. Tracee Carrasco joins us now with the latest on that part of the story, a bold move by her over the weekend.
Hey, big move. Good morning, Lauren and Cheryl. Now, Theresa May said introducing new rules worldwide for cyberspace would, quote, deprive the extremists of their safe spaces online, and that technology firms were not currently doing enough. May is putting pressure on social media websites like Facebook, Twitter, and communication apps like WhatsApp to take more responsibility for the content on their networks and in providing information to authorities that could help them foil or investigate attacks. Internet companies must not only quickly remove terrorist propaganda, they must figure out how to stop it from appearing on their platforms in the first place. Just last month, a report from The Guardian revealed exactly how Facebook's content is monitored. The report claims moderators are overwhelmed by the amount of content to keep track of. May pledges regulation of the internet, including forcing internet providers to participate in counter-extremism drives.
We need to work with allied democratic governments to reach international agreements that regulate cyberspace to prevent the spread of extremist and terrorism planning. And we need to do everything we can at home to reduce the risks of extremism online.
Last year, May introduced the Investigatory Powers Act 2016, also called the Snoopers Charter, which expands the powers of spying agencies in the UK intelligence community. The act requires internet service providers to maintain a list of visited websites for all internet users for a year and gives intelligence agencies more powers to intercept online communications. Police can access the stored browsing history without any warrant or court order. Cheryl, Lauren.
But are these companies, many of them headquartered here in the U.S., how and are they answerable to the U.K.?
You know, Facebook, they've announced that they're adding more employees to monitor this content. They just came out with a statement that said they do want to create a hostile environment for terrorists. So they are aggressively trying to get rid of this content, but it's so hard to monitor.
There's so much of
it.
Facebook, though, we should say to Mark Zuckerberg's credit, he is trying to deal with extremism on his site. So that's a good thing.
And users do have to report the terrorist propaganda that they see. So that's another issue. You know, it's only taken down once it's reported.
Yeah, Tracee, thank you.
Thanks, Tracee. Well